of the organization is within its name, Gishru. Gishru means bridge, and that's what Gishru is all about. It's meant to be that bridge between the Assyrians in the diaspora and those living in our homeland, Mesopotamia, Bit Nahrin, or modern-day Iraq, Turkey, Syria, and Iran.
It's an annual trip. Currently, it's 14 days long.
The goal of this organization is to renew the responsibility towards the ancestral homeland. It's to gain the awareness and understanding of the great Assyrian culture and the Assyrian history. And most importantly, it's to connect with your Assyrian identity.
I met a lot of new people just, you know, in the terminal at our gate. You have that excitement of, you know, going to your homeland, but at the same time meeting all these people that, you know, have the same passions as you and you're going to be spending 2 weeks with. So that was really exciting, just meeting everybody at that gate.
It's twofold. One, it connects us with the people there. We're able to forge friendships, forge partnerships, just like Gishru. Basically, Gishru is a partnership from our people there and diaspora. But also, we forget that there's also Syrians in other parts of diaspora that we don't know. We seldom think about the Syrians in Europe, in Australia.
I'm pleased to say that we now have a European member of Gishru as a director of Gishru, and just to grow our roots, to work together.
The Gishru trip happens around the time of Akitu, and we select this time is because that's the most festive time of going to our homeland.
The parade itself is overwhelming. I mean, the flag, the display of Assyrianism, the display of patriotism, the kids dressed up in julat khumala and our Assyrian traditional clothing, everybody walking together and walking for, it's not just a small parade route, it's a long route that goes all the way. So it's important and it's an amazing event.
Assuring, it's assuring. The reason I say it's assuring is because seeing the people here and seeing their pride gives me more hope that we will stay here. That's what I mean by sharing.
But as an outsider, really outside of Iraq, seeing this, I was like, wow, you know, Assyrians, we truly are diverse. You know, you saw different flags, you saw the different villages, you know, braving security threats to come celebrate this, took it to a whole nother level. And I'm glad to participate in it, and I hope to participate in many years to come.
When participants embark on this journey, their hopes are to visit their homeland, their people, archaeological sites.
We visit almost all the villages in North Iraq as time and security permitting. So the Koser dropped us off outside a pharmacy, an Assyrian pharmacy there that actually serves the majority of the area, even outside Al-Qush. We were able to just walk through the village and the streets, and I guess it happened to be just about time at the end of the school day. All these kids just started coming out of the schools and walking down the streets with their little backpacks on. No fear at all in their eyes. You can't tell that this is Iraq. You know, these kids are from Iraq and they've seen the horrors of Iraq. These are not etched on their faces at all.
Al-Qush is one of the most amazing cities you can see. It's all inhabited by Al-Qushnaya. It's preserved. It's one of the important cities within the Assyrian nation.
Every little thing about Al-Qush is Assyrian. From the pharmacy, to the teachers, to the store owners, to even the guards outside the village. Everyone there is Assyrian.
Right now we are in the Rabban Harmas Monastery in
It's absolutely amazing. We are going through all the caves that the monks carved by hand. They lived in here. They used these caves to hide in during wars. It's just absolutely amazing.
أولو اللي نيتو زايا إتشو بزنجر هي فوزنجر إتاريوة بكوزي اللي إتاريوة مصاروية قد لقي نواو ليشن تاقي بقي نواو ليشن تاق زنجر موري شاوالي لأن تلاوة ليكوز دي موري شاوالي قد هاوي أمينة قصوها هاوي أنا طول قصوها.
But for me, what was the biggest thing for me was that when I was standing up on the mountains, when I was overlooking the valley, this is the same sight that my forefathers, my ancestors, thousands of years ago have saw and seen with their own eyes. And I was able to share that experience with them. And for that, that's what's given me more hope and more motivation to continue our project with reuniting our people from the West to our homeland here in Deshtet Ninue, Bet Naharim.
Visiting the Assyrian Aid Society sponsored schools that are fully taught in Assyrian, I mean, every single course is taught in Assyrian, be it if you go to high schools, be it physics, calculus, you know, you enter a class and you see the periodic table in Assyrian, it just gives you goosebumps. And these kids are so humble and welcoming and really smart kids.
I mean, these are kids less than half my age that are learning chemistry, physics, biology, all in our native language, Assyrian. I never thought that was possible. I never even thought it would be feasible to do that. But it's happening, and it's happening as we speak.
I felt embarrassed because, one, I don't know how to read and write my language very well. So when I came back, I made it a point to start reading and writing. Me, myself, and about 30 other students are now learning and reading right Assyrian here in the U.S.
Loving, and they're so excited that we're here and they want us to stay, but they're excited that we might come again next year. Not that we might, that we're going to come again. They're all so cute. One of them was saying that she's a very smart girl, but she doesn't do her homework. So I told her by next year when we visit, she has to start doing her homework. And hopefully she agreed.
خلاص مع جبل وكل صبره زت أنه شيء ذا بيقولوا ثو حزن أطيمو دي مدرسة ثالثة ومع دريلا زتر وزتر وحيلو طالوا هذا كان هالك إنه هذا كده مرويو كده مر كات كده أنا مرويو
We wanted to experience the village life, so we got to make bread in Tanuira. She had prepared the dough for us and, you know, split it up, and she taught us how to make it, and, you know, of course everybody lined up and wanted to make this bread, and it was delicious, this bread, once it was finally done.
Hold up from the stand, you're gonna burn your hand.
Hurry, hurry.
You can comment that we were much better than the girls. None of ours had fell off or were small. There were large pieces of bread that everyone ate.
They're so welcoming here. In America, you can't even knock on somebody's door without them getting scared. Here, they just welcomed us into their house just by saying Shlama. It's like meditation. It's nice. I feel safe. I feel like we like completely left the world and went to a completely different place.
Baghdad sits in the middle, in the epicenter of the Nineveh Plains. You have 50,000 citizens living in Baghdad, of which 99% are Assyrian.
I love it because anytime you walk into a city that is your people, it's like home. Obviously, I wasn't born here, but every time I come here, this is my sixth year coming, automatically when I get off that flight and step on my land, it's I feel at home, more home than my home in California.
Unfortunately, the infrastructure is only a few notches above a village, so it still has a lot of upgrading to do.
When we were playing with some kids playing soccer, they don't have a field. They were playing in rocks-filled landfill type area where their goalposts were two cinder blocks and a garbage can. You know, we have to put our money where our mouths are. I mean, if we want to develop, no foreigner is going to help us. Nobody. We have to help ourselves, and that's important. And Baghdad is a key.
A private investor invested money into this land to build schools. So this will be a primary school, and this will be the secondary school.
It's a step in the right direction. That investment in Baghdad has profited some people, so it's not all that bad.
The land is beautiful. It needs some rehabbing. The roads need to be fixed. There needs to be a lot of cleaning as far as the environment goes. In need of more electrical rehabbing and medicine as far as pharmaceuticals go. The people are generally happy, but they're in need of more Assyrian schools, university.
The schools are not in the best condition, and there is a lack of funding for transportation of taking these children from the villages to the schools. However, the Assyrian Aid Society of Iraq steps up and provides the necessary funding to make sure these kids have the best possible education.
Unfortunately, from the government there, they don't really provide the funding in time, and they don't fund it enough. It's not at 100%.
أخلويتي لبريمي يالزور وشباب وبختاثة وناس شقور إلى يد وشتيتو كده قاوة هذه بس خبريتو خا طلع في سنة بلطي لأخو قرمي ما قرمي رغم داني بلطي
No human should endure what they did. It takes you back to that time and what they went through. It's a sight that's not for everybody.
That pottery was used for families that ate out of it and, you know, stored things in it. And those families, women, children, elders, everyone is just massacred. It's sad to see all of us bombed down there. It's like no one cares. And there's like garbage laying around. It's unprotected. They're planting vegetation. It's ridiculous. It's really sad.
What we saw was never going to, it's never going to leave you.
Just as we had to pay homage to our martyrs who sacrificed themselves to maintain our existence, we had to experience our archaeological sites, ruins, that are not only a link to our past, but also we had to see the sites that our forefathers built and are a proof of our identity, our Assyrian identity. At first sight, seeing the ruins of our capitals, Nineveh and Nimrud, and the site of Khinis, it is quite disheartening. You see the dilapidated condition of these sites, from the vandalism to the graffiti, from just the erosion from being open to the environmental elements. And as hard as it to believe, and the new construction that's being built on top of unexcavated sites, and you realize that, you know, maybe this past that we have, this link to our history, could become truly extinct in oblivion. But at the same time, it was breathtaking and overwhelming, you know, being able to see our capital up so close, going down tunnels and discovering ancient burial sites, being able to brush off tablets to reveal the underlying cuneiform engravings, being able to stand in the walls of the capital and even simply just taking pictures next to Lamassu's. It was truly this part of the trip that made, you know, going to Iraq and visiting our homeland very worthwhile.
That was one of the most touching experiences for me. I grew up on Dawood Isha songs, and being surrounded by this beauty, these mountains, and within those mountains, being surrounded by our people, waving flags, singing, was a really touching experience.
This brought tears to everybody's eyes. That was one of the best moments ever. And he's singing, Atrikhilia Bitnahran, Ana Qatak Bizimarin. He goes, my country Bitnahran, I'm singing for you. And we were there, and it was a weird, and this was our land. And if you see that view, it's just amazing. It's just breathtaking. And the people were amazing.
It was definitely sorrow and guilt for not doing enough.
I feel a little guilt when I don't go now. I feel sad when I don't go because they want to see us. They want us to be there. They want us to come.
They have this thirst of friendship there. They want to know, and they want to make certain that us Assyrians in the diaspora, we're connected with them.
There's this guilt that we've left these people. We've left our homeland, we've left them, and they're a minority, and they're such a small minority. Why? Because we've left. But there should be this hope so that when you come back with this new ignited Assyrian identity, we have this power, because we're in the diaspora, to reach out and have the world look on Iraq and pay attention to the Assyrians, to the indigenous people of Iraq.
We're only human and we can only do so much, but my hope is that the more people we bring to this trip, and it grows and grows and becomes something amazing, and then can go further from there.
Gishu would not exist. I mean, it would have just been still an idea in infancy if it wasn't for the partnerships that we have on the ground in Iraq. That consists of the Syrian Aid Society, the Syrian Democratic Movement, also known as Zawa, and mainly, let's not also forget, our peers, the Caldo-Assyrian Youth and Student Organization of Iraq.
And there's not just Assyrians from the east, there's Assyrians from the west. We're called Madin Chaya Ma'arawai, but we're all Assyrian. And I might say Shlama, you might say Shlomo, but that means the same thing. And so we should not forget that.
We're talking about Turkey, we're talking about Syria, we're talking about Iran. So Gishu 2018 will also be including trips and connections with our people in these other countries as well. I mean, let's not limit this just to Iraq. This will be broadened.
When they say, where are Assyrians, where are you? We're all over, but we need to unite and to be as one. It is a bridge that connects people, that unites people, that unites our people from all over the world. Gishru is me and you. مخنية ونقدر عمر صغد قلت كهلل إدي مال النمية يوكل خانا قولل مخنية ونقد قورا من دول ولنسورا من دشاية قمبتا تيا ووالا بورا مخنية ونشق النول جودانا جودا بجودا قرنونا تخرنية أو دن جودانا تبتا.